Hey, what is good, ladies and gentle niggas? It is your boy Moo Monkey coming at you with another episode of In the Motherfucking Lab. And today, we gonna be going in the lab with motherfucking Binya Binya, Greninja Ninja, Poliwog up in this bitch, and we gonna see what this nigga could do right now. Alright, so Kalos Pokemon go to the Kalos League, and we about to get into the nitty-gritty of this Greninja Ninja, baby. This Greninja. The nigga with the tongue scarf, tongue game strong like Greninja, baby. Alright, so if you niggas are familiar with my In the Lab series, you know that I like to talk about each character's characteristics in the beginning of each video, so you kind of know what each character's bringing to the table. So, we might as well start off with Greninja's, I guess his stats right now when it comes to speed and weight. So, when it comes to speed, Greninja is actually tied, well, not, he's not really tied with anyone, actually. I believe he's, I think he's slower than Zero Suit Samus and faster than Mewtwo. I believe he's slightly faster than Mewtwo. I thought they were tied at first, but I think Greninja is faster. So I believe Greninja is the sixth fastest character in the goddamn game. So he is pretty quick, so he's actually able to cover quite a bit of distance on the field. So that's pretty nice, pretty nice. When it comes to weight, I believe Greninja's actually tied with Lucas and Ness, for obvious reasons, since Lucas and Ness are pretty close, closely modeled after each other. They're kind of like semi-clones of one another, so they're going to be pretty similar in weight. So Greninja's tied with those two niggas, as well as Sonic. So I believe that marks for Greninja being tied for the 33rd through 36th heaviest character in the game. So yeah, that's pretty good. Greninja does possess the ability to crawl. I believe Greninja does possess the ability to wall jump. And I believe he can wall cling as well. So yeah, Greninja does have quite a bit of a tactics they could use for a recovery. Seeing how Greninja's recovery is like one of the more annoying ones to use just from personal experience. So you definitely need all the different ways to actually fake out and maneuver around your opponent as possible. So yeah. Oh, also one thing I almost forgot. When it comes to the jumping capabilities, I believe Greninja has like one of the higher jumps in the game. So that's his full jump, as you can see to Mario's. And I believe Greninja's fall speed is a lot faster than Mario's as well. So you actually see Greninja at the height that he's reaching, he's actually able to reach the ground a lot quicker than Mario. So he's able to jump higher and reach the ground before him. So that's gonna be really nice for our combos with Greninja. So yeah, crawling, wall jump, wall cling. Pretty nice, pretty standard, pretty basic. Let's get into the fancy shit, baby. Well, not really fancy shit. We're just gonna get into his basic jab. All right, so let's move Mario to the center of the stage and let's go with the first initial jab. Blap's gonna do 2%, and then we're gonna go right into, hold up, 7%. Bop, bop. So, second hit's gonna do 1%, leaving up to 3%, and that full combo's gonna do bop, bop, bop. And that's gonna do 7% for the nice 1, 2, 3, I guess they call it like a gentleman's combo or some shit like that. And Greninja has a multi-hitting attack, which will go into rapid state and do a nice move, finishing off. Nice. Ooh, hold up. Let's actually do, hold up real quick. Yeah, so that's not too bad. So you can definitely catch your opponents in it depending on how they DI. You're able to get a lot more or a lot less damage out of them. With these, certain characters like Yoshi might have super armor, and he just might say, fuck your damage. I'm just going to walk right out of it with my super armor. So you got to be mindful of shit like that. But it's still pretty nice to have a multi-hitting attack, able to stun your opponents and follow up from there. So yeah, that's pretty much Greninja's basic jabs. Then we got Greninja's down tilt, which is nice, 7%. Let's see if it does more damage towards the base. No, it looks like it does 7% near the tip and the base, I believe. Hold up. I'm going to move around a little bit. Ah, down tilt. Nope, a little closer. Ah, yeah, it looks like a 7% all around. All right, cool. We got Greninja's up tilt. There's 4% right there. Let's see how much damage it does on the other side. So 4% on this side. Let's see what Greninja's behind you. 4%. Yeah, it looks like 4% all around. All right, cool. Down tilt, forward tilt. Then we also got F tilt. Nice 7% once again. And as you can see, Greninja's quite the slippery character. Kind of like Luigi in a sense. He kind of has a little bit of a slipperiness to him. So yeah, 7% right there, and I believe you can angle his tilt, so that's gonna be really nice. Let's see, 7% right there. I wonder if it does more damage. Hold up, 4% right there. I actually want to see 4%. All right, 7% right there. 7%. Yeah, it looks like it's 7% all around. I know certain characters, when they do their tilts will actually do a lot more damage to their opponent. So probably do like 1 or 2 more percent. But yeah, this is a nice 7% even percent around. All right, cool. I'm going to reset Mario's percent. Hold up. Make him come back. All right, cool. So that's pretty much all of Greninja's tilts. We also have his dash attack. He's going to do a nice 7%. So it looks like his down tilt, his F tilt, his dash attack's all going to do 7%. Yeah, it looks like it's all doing 7%. Let's see her again. Yeah, all 7%. All right, cool. So I'm gonna get Mario off the ledge. Bop, bop, bop. There we go. All right, so we talked about his jazz, we talked about his tilt, his dash attack. We could get right into Greninja's grabs then. So pummeling is gonna do nice 2%, it looks like. Hold up, let's grab Mario. Pummel. Yeah, it looks like do nice 2%. Not bad. Let's go for a down throw. Down throw is gonna do 5%. Up throw is gonna do 5% as well. Back throw is gonna do 8%. All right, cool. And I believe forward throw is gonna do 5%. All right, cool. Did you do up throw? Up throw is 5%. Do you do down throw? Down throw is gonna do 5%. All right, so it looks like all of his moves, his down, up, and forward is gonna do 5, whereas back is gonna do 8. All right, cool. I'm gonna actually see. Well, obviously, everything's gonna kill at 90. Yeah, everything's gonna kill at that percent. I'm gonna go right to 120. Yeah, 120 probably be a good percent. I should try to see around like 110, 120 to see what moves are gonna kill. I think that's a nice gauge of where most moves will start killing. So you kind of get like a ballpark range of like how effective a move's gonna kill around this area. I'm gonna see how good the back throw is. Does that kill? No, a 128. 120 doesn't look like it's killing any time. It's like no crater lines or anything. Like, you know when you hit an opponent hard enough, you start to see like those red streaks? I'll demonstrate right here. As you see that like that red trail that follows Mario? You can kind of see like if a move is gonna be pretty potent, if that move actually has that trail, but I'm not seeing no type of trail. As you can see right there pretty briefly, I'm not seeing anything like that for Mario. I'm just seeing smoke right now. All right, I see a trail for Mario when you throw him upward. Down throw, yeah, not seeing a trail or anything. Forward throw, not see a trail or anything. So I'm guessing the best possible for killing is probably gonna be for up throw. And that's probably gonna kill around like what, 170, 175? Let's see, 175. Let's see. Yeah, it looks like 175, probably even 170. Let's try it. And even that seems like a, I don't think that's gonna be that good of a kill move to go for. Yeah, 175, let's see, 165. All right. Does that kill? Yeah, 165 will kill. I'm guessing 165 will be the tipping point. I don't think Mario is going to die at 160, meaning that depending on how good your DI is, you might die, you might not die around 160. All right, cool. So that's pretty much all of Greninja's grabs and his kill power. So we might as well go right into Greninja's aerials. All right, so let's start off with Greninja's Nair. Nair's going to do a nice 11%, so that's pretty good. Oh, I see a sour hit of a 6%, it looks like. Let's see. Yeah, 6% sour hit right there. All right, interesting. 11% for the sweet spot. Then we also got Greninja's forward air. It's going to do a nice 14%. I wonder if it does more percent depending on how close we are. See, 14% right here. I wonder if it does more percent towards the tip. Let's see. Yeah, see, I'm still seeing 14%. All right, cool. His forward air seems like a nice good killing move, though, too. Yeah, looks like a nice good killing move. Mario's already at 126. Look, he might die. Looks like he is dead. And keep in mind, the closer you are to the edge of the stage, obviously, the easier it is going to be kill you. So throwing an attack like that will be a lot easier for Greninja. We also have Greninja's up air, which is a nice racking up multi-hitting move right there. Hold up. There we go. So it looks like it does 9% for his up air. All right, cool. So 9% for his up air, really nice right there. We also have his back air, which is also a nice multi-hitting move. I want to see how much damage it does altogether. Yeah, 6% altogether for the back air. Not bad. Then we also have Greninja's down air, which is a spiking move. Keep in mind, Greninja will rocket straight down if he doesn't touch anything. So you want to be mindful of that. So let's see, try to catch Mario. Yeah, sometimes Mario will not rocket straight down. Sometimes he'll be sent upwards. I think it depends on, I don't know what exactly depends on to actually get the spike off, but I do know the spike is possible. You just gotta be, I guess, mindful. There you go. I guess it'd be at the dead center of his foot. Otherwise, let's try it. We'll try to catch Mario at the side. Yeah, let's at the side, you won't get rocket down. You have to be like directly under them. I mean, on top of them. Yeah, so right there, Mario did not get rocket downward. He actually just went to the side. So you definitely want to be careful of that. Cool, looks like Nair's killing around like 160 or some shit like that. All right, cool. So yeah, that's pretty much all of Greninja's arrows. Is that all his arrows? We talked about his Nair. We talked about his fair. We talked about his back air. We talked about his back air. Down here. I guess we could talk about the kill power of each one of his moves. So what I probably will do, I'm going to actually bump Mario up to 110. And we're going to see how quickly Greninja's aerial is going to start killing. So right off the bat, I'm going to tell you right now, Nair is not going to kill anytime soon. I pointed out that it was killing up to like, what, 170 or some shit like that. So you definitely want to be mindful of that. His forward air, I think it's just one of his strongest aerials. But you definitely want to make sure that you're at the side of the stage and throwing it out. It's killing as low as, I believe. Hold on, bring it down over here. Wait for it to come back over here. Now let's see. Alright, 110's not killing. Alright, Mario's dead. I'm gonna bump him to 120. Alright, let's see if try to hit Mario back over here. There we go. Back here doesn't look like it's gonna be killing anytime soon as well. Looks like it's gonna be a nice racking up percent move. Not more so much as a killing move. Yeah, you probably won't even want to use it for kind of like racking up percent and kind of like walling out your opponent. But I'm going to actually bring Mario down to 120. Let's see when this forward air starts killing. All right, so it looks like 120 would probably be the around the point where Mario will start dying for this forward air. Hold up. I'm going to actually swipe him again. I said swipe. I said swipe. I said swipe. There we go. I'm going to actually bump him down to 126. Can you make it? Hey, I'm going to bump him up to 130. There you go. Not 130. I want to actually bring it down. I'm going to bring it down to 115. All right, let's see if 115 will kill at the side of stage. Will that kill? No. All right, so it looks like 120 it is for like the tipping point for killing Mario with that forward air. All right, cool. All right, not bad. All right, so we talked about his back air. Did we talk about his up air? No, up air not yet. All right, so let's see. Up air. Obviously, once again, the higher you are when throwing out that up air, the easier to kill out your opponent. So given that Greninja has like a pretty high jump peak, it's going to be pretty easy to get that nice up air kill, seeing how you're going to be so close to the top of the stage. Actually, want to go for up tilt first, but then go for that. There he goes. So yeah, he's able to kill out as early as like 129. Oh, let's see again. Pop him up. Yeah, so as early as like 129. Actually, hold up. I'm going to actually, Oh yeah, keep in mind, since it is a multi-hitting move, you can actually drag down your opponent. Certain moves that have like multi-hits, if you drag your opponent back down to the stage, you can actually have like some type of momentum. As you can see right there, you can actually drag your opponent down to the ground with it. All right, cool. So that's pretty much all of Greninja's aerials, I think, when it comes to killing. Nair not going to be so much good for killing. Dare is only pretty much going to be good for when it comes to offstage pressure. You're only probably going to get like a sure kill if you're offstage when going for the dare. Once again, it is a risk because if you do it off the stage, you're going straight down. You can't cancel out of it depending on how high you are when doing it, but the lower you are, the harder it is for you to come back. So I do caution you when throwing it out, especially if your opponent is evasive as fuck. So yeah. So, that's pretty much all of Greninja's aerials. I guess all we have to worry about now is Greninja smash attack. So, I'm going to actually bump him down to a good old 0%. And let's worry about his smash attacks. All right, so let's get into Greninja's smash attack. So, forward smash, just flicking the sticks, going to do a nice 14%. Not bad. Down smash, going to do a nice 11% right there. Then, we also got up smash, going to do a nice 11% as well. All right, cool. I'm going to actually set Mario back to stop. Alright, so let's get into Greninja's smash attack. So, I'm going to flick the stick for the forward smash to do a nice 14%. It looks like that's going to be pretty nice and potent. Let's see if it does more damage towards the tip. 14%, nope. Alright, let's see if it's a little closer. Still 14%. Alright, cool. Let's do down smash. Looks like it's doing 11%. That's from the front, so let's see how much it does from the back. Alright, looks like it's a nice 11% all around. All right, let's see the same thing for up smash. Alright, cool. And, ooh, is that dead? Yeah, it looks like 13. Hold up. I saw 13%, and I don't think I charged it. I might have charged it. I don't know. Oh, no. I see 13% once again. All right, so it looks like you might do more percent towards it. All right, so there it is. That's what I was curious to see. It looks like Greninja's down smash. It does more damage towards the tip of it. So let's see. Try to space myself out properly. Yeah, so that's doing 13%, whereas the base is going to do 11%. And let's see if that's the same with the forward smash. I don't think it's going to do more damage towards the tip. Nope, still 14%. And still 14%. All right, cool. Now, I believe for the up smash, I believe, yeah, he does more damage because it's a two-part hitting up smash. One where he crosses his swords and one where he kind of just like breaks it apart. So he's going to do 19% for that up smash. All right, cool. That's not too bad. All right, so that's Greninja's smash attacks. We might as well bump it right back up from where we came from, back up to that 110, 120, and start seeing when these smash attacks will start bodying niggas. That's the best part. That's the favorite part of these videos, when things start kicking the bucket. So I'm going to stop Mario right at 110, and let's see this forward smash. So just looking at it real quick. All right, let's say Mario's not going to die from that. All right, cool. And also keep in mind, I'm not really charging it up. I'm just like flicking out. Charging up for the forward smash is going to do 19% right there. Pretty nice knockback, pretty crazy knockback. Up smash, all the way up, gonna do 15%, and that's not with the crossing part, so obviously gonna do a lot more damage like that. If I hit Mario up like that and I charge it up, hold on, I'm gonna try to set Mario to jump. Let's set him to jump. There we go. I'm gonna position myself under him. Pop, pop. Yeah. So that's gonna do 19. I'm gonna charge it up though. Let's try to charge it up. Pop, pop. Yeah, that's gonna be 26% for that up smash. That's pretty lethal right there. And charging it up for a down smash. Hold up. I'm trying to time it up. There you go. So that's gonna be 18% for that shit. All right. So yeah, that's pretty much charging it up. But I'm not really charging up the smash attacks. I'm just flicking it out because most likely in a battle, you're not gonna be charging up a move unless you're getting a hard read. All right. So what I definitely want to do, I actually want to bring Mario to the middle of the stage where it can get a nice kind of even and consistent placement of Mario when throwing out these attacks. So let's start off with a forward smash. All right, looks like that's not gonna kill Mario. All right, cool. All right, so 110 is not gonna cut it. It's not gonna cut it. So we need to move it up to probably like 120. All right, let's go for that forward smash right now. Lap. All right, so looks like 120 will kill Mario. All right, let's see if 115 will kill him. All right, wait for Mario to bring his ass back down. Whack, will it kill him? All right, so looks like it is gonna be 120. Let's actually bump it down back to 110. And let's see when this down smash will start killing. I'm gonna try, well, I should be charging the full one. Full one is obviously gonna kill. All right, let's see if the regular one will kill. Will that kill? No, that's not gonna be enough to kill. I'm gonna bump Mario up to 120. Let's see if the down smash will kill then. Will that kill him? No, not yet. All right, so I'm gonna bump up to 125. Let's see if 125 will kill Mario. Will that kill him? No, he's still surviving. All right, let's try 130 then. Yeah, looks like 130 will definitely be it. All right, cool. So 130 for the down smash for killing purposes. And let's see if that's the same thing for the back part of it. Yeah, it looks like all around it's going to kill at 130. All right, that's not too bad, not too bad. All right, so for the up smash, I'm actually going to set Mario to jump. And I'm going to go for it. Actually, I'm going to bump his percent back down to 110. Back down to 110. And let's try to get him at the peak of it. There you go. What I would definitely want to do, the reason why I'm getting him to jump is I want to try to get him in that two-part hitting move. That we can kind of see like the optimal percent. All right, so that's 19 right there. I'm going to bump him down to 100. All right, let's see if 100 will kill him. Will that kill? Yeah, it's killing at 100. All right, cool. I'm going to bring him down to 95. Let's just do 90. There you go. Will that kill at 90? Yeah, it looks like it is killing at 90. All right, interesting. Let's try 85. Was that killing? All right, so 85 looks like 90 is gonna be that tipping point where the attack may or may not kill opponents. So that's gonna be really interesting. Depending on your DI, you might be able to survive that at 90. All right, cool. So that's pretty much all of Greninja's smash attack. We talked about his grabs, we talked about his aerials. All we have really left to talk about is Greninja's motherfucking special. So we might as well get right into that right away. So I'm gonna bump Mario back down to, it don't really matter. We can bring Mario right down to, I guess 30. It doesn't really matter. Doesn't matter the percent. As long as you get not getting tossed around like a college schoolgirl, we should be good. All right. So what I probably will do, I'm gonna go right for the stop. I'm gonna throw out the water shuriken, and that's gonna do 11% when fully charged. Throwing it out normally is gonna do 3%. And I believe when throwing it out, he actually kind of like stalls in the air, so you can kind of use it as like placement. So charging it up. I don't know if like the more stronger it is. Nah, it looks like it's the same amount. Like it's popping up. And I believe it only works for that first one. First one pop him up, and the rest of them, he just like continue to fall. Hold on, let me try it again. So pop. Yeah, it looks like he just continues to fall. Yeah, he just continues to fall with the shuriken. So that first initial one, he would kind of like pop up a little bit. Kind of noticeable. All right, cool. So yeah, 11%, and it kind of drags your opponent along. So it's kind of nice right there. The little ones are kind of like this 3%. I want to see what's the distance for this. All right, so it's like almost like half the map, honestly. Yeah, it looks like it's half the map. It looks like when it's fully charged, it doesn't go nearly as far as it does when it's like small. So let's see. We'll go right here, charge it up. Almost touching Mario. Hold on, let me see. Yeah, so that's touching Mario right there. So let's see. If I stand right here, I'm pretty sure it's gonna touch Mario. Yeah, it's gonna hit Mario right there. I'm gonna actually bring Mario. I'm gonna make Mario stand on this little yellow triangle right here. And let's see, if I stand right about here, will it hit Mario? Yeah, so that'll hit Mario. I'm gonna actually put Mario back on that yellow triangle and make sure I actually charge it up all the way. And let's see how far this thing goes. Yeah, so it doesn't reach Mario. Hold up, let's try this. All right, so that doesn't touch him. Oh, that isn't smart either. Interesting. That will touch him right here. All right, so I want to stand right about here on that purple. All right. So I'm giving myself like little visual markers on the floor. So probably like right around here. All right, let's see. Right about here. Charge it up. Yeah, so that's going right outside Mario's face. This one will touch him. So yeah, it won't go as far as just throwing it out if you charge it up. So keep that in mind. But the damage is really nice. 12% for the whole water shuriken right there. So that's not too bad. All right, so that's about enough of the water shuriken. That nice projectile right there. Keep in mind it can be reflected, deflected, and all type of erection. But keep in mind the water shuriken is a projectile, so it can be deflected, reflected, ejected, erected, and all that good shit. So you want to be careful, especially dealing with Ness. I don't know if Ness can actually heal it up. I'll probably check right now. All right, so let's get right into Greninja's other special. Let's go for a side B. Side B, Shadow Sneak, really nice move. As you can see, you can actually jump and move when throwing it out. You actually see like a shadow cast out from Greninja, so you definitely want to be mindful of that. You can do it in the air as a recovery, so it's going to be really nice. Keep in mind, let me see something real quick. If I throw it out, all right, yeah, so Greninja will be able to move after that. I don't know if he'll take away his jumps. No, looks like he will still have his jumps. Hold up. Yeah, looks like he still has his jumps when throwing it out. All right, cool. So I wanted to be sure Greninja was not going to be left vulnerable when throwing out that Shadow Sneak. All right, cool. Pretty interesting move. So you're able to, like, avoid attacks, get around attacks, like, say, Mario throws out a fireball. You're able to throw out your Shadow Sneak, get bypassed it, and get up inside Mario's face real quick. So that's pretty nice. Pretty nice right there. All right, cool. All right, so the next move that we have for Greninja, next special, is going to be his Hydro Pump. And pretty much his Hydro Pump is kind of like Pikachu's Quick Attack, but unlike Pikachu's Quick Attack, where you have to kind of change your direction to get the extra kind of like angle, you just have to hold it in a direction. Greninja will automatically do that two pulse. So it doesn't matter which way you do, you can kind of go up, down, you can kind of go back and forth, you can kind of go diagonal up, diagonal down. You can do it pretty much anywhere you really need to go. So you can never mess with it. As you can see, Mario got pushed back. So you can actually see that there's actually a wind box on it. So you can actually push your opponents around with this Hydro Pump and actually mess around with recovery. So that's going to be really nice. So that's pretty much Greninja's upbeat. And then last but not least for Greninja specials, we have his counter. Now his counter is kind of interesting because you can do it in many different directions. You can actually do it in a sideways, you can do it upwards, you can do it downwards. I'm waiting for Mario to come back down. Shoot that fireball real quick again. Counter, and I can angle it upward, I can angle it sideways. Hold up. So you can actually angle it in many different directions. So if Mario was to shoot a fireball and I counter and I angle upwards, Greninja will rocket straight up into the air. Mario could also shoot out a fireball again. I counter and I go downward. So it goes right above. It looks like it will heat seek directly on whoever threw that attack out. So that's pretty cool. So Greninja's counter is kind of like directional, almost like Lucario's, which you kind of like go in a certain direction. Well, Greninja, you can actually control which direction that you go in. So yeah, that's pretty much Greninja in a nutshell though. Pretty nice moves, pretty mobile. A lot of his moves are pretty much for like tricky, especially when it comes to the counter. You can actually follow up with some of the moves. Like if you go like a counter and you counter upwards, you could probably follow with like an up air or some other move right there. So yeah, that's pretty much Greninja in a nutshell. Once again, I don't really know Greninja like that, but I'm pretty sure there's people that know Greninja a lot better than me down in the comment section. So if you know any Greninja tips and tricks, feel free to comment down below. But for direct next time, we gonna be here in the same exact place as we usually do, in the lab with another cat, the baby. All right, peace.